and the power of truth. Knowing the truth, believing the truth, accepting the truth, obeying the truth, living truthfully, and bringing glory to God by the power of the truth, you've been impacted. If you don't know the truth, you have no place in the scheme of divine agenda. Not knowing the truth will automatically program your life out of the will and counsel of your maker. If you don't know the truth, you are in trouble with Satan and all his cohorts. If you don't know the truth, you will beg your enemies spiritually. You will feed on crumbs spiritually. You are not serving God at all, because the secret of God is unknown to those who know the truth. The secret of God is with them who know the truth and they do justice to it. If you don't know the truth, you can't make heaven. In Psalm 32 and in verse 8, it says, I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way whither thou shalt go, and I will consciously and deliberately guide you with my eyes. There is the need for you to seek after the truth, pant after the truth, so that you will not be among those who will languish eternally in hellfire. In Proverbs chapter 23, verse 23, it says, buy the truth and sell it not. Deception is rampant globally in churches. Ministers are not preaching the truth today because of what they want to eat and what they want to become, forgetting that wherever you are and whatever you have ends in this world. No matter what the world has given you, the world will collect it from you before you die. Whatever you have in this world, you go to the world before having them, you will live with nothing. The Bible says, he that lives in pleasure while he's alive is dead already, spiritually. There are three important truths you must know, you must accept, and you must behave as if they are your end. Number one, the truth about God, the truth about eternity, and the truth about yourself. Listen, the truth about God is that God is love, yet, on the other hand, God is terrible. God is great. God is wonderful. On the other hand, God can be very, very dangerous in decision. I was privileged to visit the Holy Land in 2012. And I got to Sodom and Gomorrah. And over there, I bent down to test the sand of that place and the stone of the place. Lo and behold, they were both salty. And then I remembered Mrs. Lot, who became an evil memorial in the kingdom. And when Jesus came, he was teaching his disciples in Luke chapter 17, verse 32. It will surprise you that the latter end of Mrs. Lot's wife became a verse of the Bible. Jesus said, remember Lot's wife. Remember Lot's wife. If you finish your life the way she did, you are going to meet her in hell. The truth about God is that anybody can go to hell and God will still be God. Anybody can repent and he will be forgiven. Eternity is long. I'm repeating myself again. If you get into eternity unprepared, you will regret it. And unfortunately, there wouldn't be any second chance for you. The truth about your life. Who are you? Where are you in the scheme of God's calendar? Think about this. Come to know the truth and you will be saved. Jesus is calling you. Believe him today. Accept him today. And your name will enter into the book of life. I'm not here to talk about politics. I'm not here to talk about any other thing. But that your soul is so important to God. And God wants your soul to be saved. Won't you come unto him now? I'm giving you the opportunity. Surrender your life. Jesus loves you. Once you are still alive, you can repent. But the moment you die, that's the final. The final of everything is at hand. When you leave this world, you lose total control over yourself and life. God bless you as you make up your mind to accept Jesus. See you in eternity. Blessed are your ears for hearing these things. It will do.